This is my optimal day trading setup with a gaming tower and multiple displays. And we're gonna be talking about the technical specs and the cost of this build in the video. So after the reverse split strategy video from last week, I got a lot of comments asking me why I didn't call him back.
Did your girlfriend or boyfriend or your wife or husband yell at you this week? Then destroy that like button and then call them back, of course. Seriously though, I should have called him back.
Just kidding, no one cares about him. I actually got a lot of questions asking me about this new day trading setup. Technically, the setup isn't that new. I just haven't shown it because it was extremely messy and I finally cleaned it up. And I really just need an excuse to stand up for this video because we just had Thanksgiving weekend and I just really need to get off my fat ass. So I thought it'd be really cool to show you guys my trading setup, all the specs and how much it's cost, and I'll explain to you why exactly I need all these screens. Spoilers, it's for watching YouTube videos and destroying those like buttons. So this tower has graphics card from ticker symbol NVDA, NVIDIA RTX 2060 with I think 6 gigs of memory, as well as ticker symbol INTC, Intel i5 9600 hexa-core CPU. The funny thing is, after day trading for a few years, you start reading into stores and brands by their stock symbols. Anyway, so that's a CPU and a GPU. This build also has 240 gigs of SSD, 1 terabyte of standard disk drive, and also 16 gigs of RAM and water cooling. Okay, so I know I just dropped tons of technical geeky terms, and you're probably wondering, humble trader, what exactly does all that technical jargon mean? So let me explain all the technical jargon right now. I have no clue. So this is what happened. I went to all my gamer friends who are much smarter than me and much more knowledgeable about all these computers and graphics card. And I just said to them, hey man, I need to build a PC for day trading, not gaming. But I care about speed, stability, and I need to be able to run 4 monitors with charts simultaneously. And this is what they suggested for day trading setup. Get at least a 250 gigs of SSD, which stands for solid state drive. And that is much faster than the standard disk drive. You also need at least 8 gigs of RAM. RAM is really important because it allows your computer to run multiple processes simultaneously. RAM is very important to me because I need to be able to run scanners, news alerts, and multiple brokers, and also be able to watch YouTube videos. Next is a CPU, which is like the command central for your computer. My gamer friends recommended at least an i5 quad-core processor with at least a speed of 3.3 gigahertz. If you could get an Intel i7 or i9, would be even better than what I have. And as for the GPU, my friend suggested to not cheap out on this, since I'll be needing it to run multiple displays and running videos and other graphics. So it's best to get at least an NVIDIA GTX graphics card with at least 4 gigs of RAM. And as for the water cooling, I don't think it's really necessary unless you're actually gaming. I just got it with a build, and we're gonna talk about where I got it and the cost breakdown in just a little bit. But before we move on, let's not forget about these cute little plants that's part of my trading setup. They're probably gonna die soon. There's 3 things I'm absolutely terrible at in life. First, taking care of plants, cooking, and telling jokes that are actually funny. Next, we're gonna look at my 4 displays. All 4 of these are from LG, 24-inch LED monitor with 75 hertz of refresh rate. The colors are amazing on these. I was debating for a long time whether to get those horizontal curved screens, but those are not cheap, and I need at least 2 34 to 37 inch curved monitors and stack it vertically. But at the end, I decided that I'd much rather spend the money on the tower build, and I'm actually looking to get 2 more vertical screens like these on each side, so I don't have to minimize any of my scanners or newswire or anything like that. Right now, I need all 4 of these displays for my charts with multiple time frames. The daily, of course, the weekly, sometimes a 3-minute and a 5-minute. And as for the keyboard, I broke my gaming keyboard a couple of weeks ago when I spilled beer on it. And by beer, I mean water. So right now, I just have this as a backup. it works, it's perfectly fine, but I need to get one of those RGB keyboards to match with my gaming tower. And as for the mouse, I can't really use a standard mouse that you guys usually see. I have to use an ergo vertical mouse over here, and that's because my right arm is kind of injured from a previous computer intensive job and from a lot of sports injuries and most importantly from smashing too many like buttons. But the real upgrade this time around from 2 weeks ago is this vertical monitor quad mount from Vivo. It's almost perfect, and I'll show you what I mean in a little bit. It's extremely sturdy. It can hold 4 screens up to 30 inches, and it also has a cable management system at the back. So that's where I get organized all the DPI cords and HDMI cords from my 4 displays connecting to my PC tower. So you can adjust the screens left and right. You can kind of also like tilt it up and down. You can do that to all the screens here. You can adjust it however you want. So it's very versatile. You can also move the entire row, so both of these together move up or down, but you have to release the clamp from the back. So we're not gonna do that today. Now, the biggest thing that bothers me so much about this monitor mount is the fact that it's extremely difficult to adjust the screen so they align perfectly side by side. Like, there's always like a little bit of a gap between the two monitors, and like it's just so hard to adjust them to fit perfectly. Like, they are always just, the rotation is always just slightly off, and like the tilt, there's always, I don't know if you can see this, but there's always just like a slight gap in between. And seeing that every single day honestly like stresses me out. So I don't know if any of you are as OCD as I am, but let me know in the comment section below if this kind of tiny bit of offset would bother you. But really, other than the tiny alignment issue, I really like this vertical mount. Let's talk about the cost now. The vertical mount was about $60. The monitors were about $120 each. That's not bad at all. I think all of these things are relatively cheap. But the biggest cost is definitely the PC gaming tower, which I would suggest you to spend the majority of your budget on if you're looking to build a trading computer. Sure, the vertical displays are cool and all, but really it's a RAM, the CPU, and the GPU that's gonna make all the difference for you in day trading. I got the entire PC tower for $1,570 Canadian, which is like $20 US. Just kidding, I think it's about $1,180 in US dollars, which I think it's a great deal. Also, you definitely don't need an RTX graphics card unless you're actually gaming. An NVIDIA GTX will do just fine, and that will save you a couple hundred of dollars. I got the entire tower built from Canada Computers. For my Canadian friends, feel free to check them out in person or online. The staff there is really knowledgeable, and the prices are really reasonable as well. As for my American friends, I don't know if you guys have US computers, but you guys definitely have Amazon. By the way, this video is not sponsored by anyone. If you want to be able to trade remotely on a laptop, I used to use Asus ROG 15-inch gaming laptop, and I would just hook it up to 2 USB portable displays. So that works pretty well. I'm definitely not the most technical expert right here, but after consulting with my gaming friends, this is what I have, and this is a trading setup I use every single day, and it works perfectly for me. I'll put all the specs and all the details in the description below. Let me know in the comment section below what kind of trading setup you have. And as always, if you enjoyed the video and my bad jokes, always remember to annihilate the like button below and subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching as always, and I'll see you guys next week. Oh, and we definitely cannot forget about these lucky cats that I have from Japan. These are my lucky charm for day trading. They are so cute.